Hey guys, it's Yolo Master 69 here. We're coming at you with some SMT1 gameplay. So I didn't really plan what I was gonna say, but SMT1, this is just one of my favorite games from the Super Nintendo, and this game is fucking awesome. Of course, we're gonna be playing the Aeon Genesis patch, the original Aeon Genesis patch, because I don't know how to find the fixed patch, so there's gonna be some bugs. I think I remember hearing that the Aeon Genesis patch had some issues where you were locked out of certain routes and that you couldn't buy ammo in the beginning of the game from the antique shop. So we're gonna be trying the neutral route on this playthrough, or at least that's what I want to go for. So I want to go for it neutral. So yeah, let's start the game. This game's just fucking awesome. Alright, here we are in the dream world. I just love the visuals of this game. A lot of people can't seem to, a lot of people can't get used to it, but I think that old, Shin Megami Tensei has its own flair. Like, it has its own uniqueness to it, its own, I love the look of the older Shin Megami Tensei games, not to knock the newer games, because the newer games look fucking awesome also, but I just love that classic, DOS menu style look, even though it's very cluttered and stuff. The menus in SMT1 and the interface in general, and later on, after I beat SMT1, I wanna do, Shin Megami Tensei 2, I wanna do, Kyaku Megami Tensei, both, Megami Tensei 1 and 2, and we're gonna name our character Kaz, because, Kazuya, I think, is the canon name for the SMT1 protagonist, but we're gonna call him Kaz, because Kaz from Metal Gear, so fuck yeah. So this is a very important part of the game, is to divide your parameter or your points among your parameters smartly. This game's not really balanced well, so certain stats are more important than other stats. So since the at least for Super Nintendo era Shin Megami Tensei games, you never want to dump any points into magic, because your characters can't use magic in mainline Shin Megami Tensei, or at least in the Super Nintendo games. Later on in Strange Journey, SMT4, and SMT4 Apocalypse, you can. And oh my god, I love Apocalypse. A lot of people like to shit on SMT4 Apocalypse, but that game is, oh yes. I don't care if people say it was personified or whatever. I think that the cast in that game is fucking awesome. And I totally shit Nanashi as Choki. That is my ship of all ships. All the characters in that game were great. Asahi, Hallelujah, Navar, Nozomi, Gaston, Isabel. Am I missing any party members? Anyways, they were all useful. So when I played that game, I went for the friendship route, because why the fuck not? I like that peace ending. I want to do the anarchy route, which I am currently doing on my 3DS, because I wanted to get Satan, and, well, I did get Satan, and I got Merkaba, Lucifer. I'm trying to finish up my compendium in that game, but I still have to get the Zealot and Fame Demon, which are the only ones I'm missing in that game. Here is our law hero, who we will name, I think Yoshio is what I named him. Sorry, like the dubbing that I'm doing right now was recorded after I played the game, because my phone is quirky like that, where I can't record the... Because I'm recording the gameplay through an emulator, so it's kind of, originally I was going to call him Yuji, but I think I went with Yoshio, but, anyways, I couldn't record both, gameplay audio and the, voice dub at the same time, I don't think, and hopefully, I can have both at the same time on my phone. I just got this new phone. It's a Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus. And it's the 8 Plus, and I fucking love this thing. This thing is awesome. You can play PS1. This is the last, this is the video with the JoJo I just recently did shows. Alright. So Yoshio is more of a mage character. So we're gonna dump his points more into magic and intelligence. And I think speed is what I also put. Yeah, with Law Hero, you want him to be more you want him to be more focused like that, because he'll be your healer for majority of the game until you get, I think, the female heroine. Until then, I think he's more of your healer character. He has his Zan skills too, and he has Dia, but yeah. I just love this game, like the visuals and everything. I always loved Kazumi Kaneko's art style, like the older Shin Megami Tensei games, especially with Nocturne's art style. Oh my god, how can I miss Nocturne earlier? Nocturne is... Oh my god, I fucking love that game. That game is amazing. One of my favorite games of all time. Along with Digital Devil Saga and Persona 3. Obviously, I'm a huge Megami Tensei fan, and here's the Chaos Hero, which we're gonna name Takeshi, which is his canon name, but I also want to name him Takeshi because of Takeshi from Aoni, because it's kind of funny. So we're dividing his parameters. I think I made him more of a physical fighter, I believe. Yeah, I did. I made him more physical. Yeah, intelligence in this game. I think there's a stat in this game that you can raise for demon negotiations to go better. And I think that's the intelligence stat, I think, helps more with demon negotiations, if I'm correct. But it's a very useful stat to raise, but it's more of something you want to raise on a mage type character or your protagonist. Which I don't remember how much intelligence I put on my protagonist. But, I think I put enough. And there's Yuriko. protagonist is gonna start waking up from his dream as his mom starts to wake him up. And this is when he should get the demon summoning program from Steven on his computer. I just love this game. It's, I don't know. It has charm. I wouldn't recommend it to a lot of people just because it's such a hard game and it's a where the fuck do I go type of game. But if you can put yourself like in the mindset of a RPG fan from the 90s, then it's an amazing game. Well, the early 90s. I guess there wasn't really that many RPG fans in the early 90s, at least with video game RPGs, because I guess JRPGs weren't as common in the US until Final Fantasy VII came out, and this game didn't even come out in America until it was released on iOS a long time ago. The first SMT game to come out in America was Jack Brothers on the Virtual Boy, but that doesn't count. So I'm gonna say the first SMT game in America was Persona, which went under Revelations Persona on PlayStation 1. Yep, that game's also pretty awesome. That's also another game that aged pretty badly. I would love to do a Let's Play of that game, but that game also does a lot of things that piss me off. Like, I really hate the grid combat in Persona 1, but I really love the characters in that game, too. The characters in that game are awesome. And I would be doing Persona 5 gameplay right now if I could, but with how Atlas blocked the recording features on the PlayStation 4, I can't record Persona 5 right now. And I love that game. I have nothing but praise for that game. Like, it is probably the best RPG I've ever played. But I can't show you how awesome Persona 5 is because Atlas, at least Atlas of Japan, is not letting me. So I guess I'll show you the second best thing, and that's SMT 1. Well, it's not the best, the second best thing. It's a great game, don't get me wrong, but I'm not suggesting that SMT 1 is the best SMT. I'd say, well, I love Digital Devil Saga's music. I love Strange Journey's music. I love how edgy Nocturne is. And I love the fact that Dante's in the game. I think Apocalypse is my favorite, honestly. SMT4, I love that game too, but normal SMT4 has a lot of issues. Just with how brutal the beginning of that game is, and then also how the map layout for Tokyo is kind of like, eh. It fixed a lot of the problems with normal SMT4 in Apocalypse, I feel. Double Survivor games are pretty cool. I like Double Survivor. They're not my favorite, surprisingly. It seems like everybody I know and every other SMT fan I've come across has Double Survivor or one of the Double Survivor games as their favorite. I mean, they're great, but I think I like mainline. Yeah, I like mainline better. And then when it comes to Persona versus mainline, that's where it gets a little bit harder for me to decide which I like more. Because I love Persona 3. It's probably one of my favorite games in the whole FGC franchise. And I will always have like a soft spot in my heart for Persona 4 Golden, since that was the first SMT game I've ever played. But I really love mainline SMT also. I feel like mainline SMT as a whole is very underappreciated and overshadowed by Persona. I'm by no means a SMT-only elitist, but I feel like Persona's more anime tropes and aesthetics overshadow Persona, or SMT. Anyways, back to the gameplay, because I just went on this long-ass tangent about mainline and Persona. So here we're going to talk to Pascal. He's going to say bow wow. That's what dogs do, apparently. We got our money from our mom, and we're heading out to get her coffee. Kichijoji. We're inside the mall. There are the punks. Douchebags. Alright, we'll talk to random people. I'm doing the dubbing over the video. But the preview video while I'm doing the dubbing is extremely slow. Like, it's like frame for frame. So I don't want the dubbing to be off, but I don't know if it's gonna be off by nature. So hopefully my dubbing isn't off, because it'll seem very confusing. Whoever's watching this, if anyone watches this, but if you are watching this, thank you, because I guess I don't really have any quality to my videos. I try my best, but it's a pain in the ass, to be honest. I've always wanted to do YouTube full time, but with the way things are going, and with how I only have 20 subscribers, that's not gonna happen. We're talking to people inside the cafe right now. Right. Now let's go get the coffee. Again, I would read the text, but it's going like frame per frame, so I don't want to do that, because it will seem very, it'll be off if I do that. Alright, so we're gonna head back to the house. Oh no, I think we go back behind the drugstore first, like with the guy. The knife from the corpse of the crazy guy, or well, who everybody thought was crazy. Turns out he wasn't so crazy. And man, wouldn't SMT1 make for a great ass anime or movie? Well, most SMT games would make for a badass anime or movie. I've had this thought on my mind like forever, because I know how Persona 3 has a movie, and Persona 4 has two anime series, and I'm surprised Persona 4 didn't end up getting a movie like Persona 3, which would be kind of redundant since there's already two anime series of Persona 4. But anyways, back on topic. SMT 1, a lot of other SMT games other than Persona and Devil Survivor would make for amazing animes or amazing movies. I especially think Strange Journey would make an awesome movie. I can imagine Strange Journey as a live action aliens type movie, because it has that really heavily Strange Journey is mostly sci-fi, and that game is, oh my god, yeah, that game would be fucking amazing. Speaking of the new Aliens movie, I haven't seen Alien Covenant, but I have heard it's shit, and I heard it shits all over the alien lore, and I heard it's one of the worst in the franchise. I haven't seen it yet, so I'm not gonna give a personal opinion, that's just what I've heard. I wanna see it, because I'm a huge fan of Alien. Well, Alien and Aliens. 3 was meh. Resurrection was laughable. Alien vs. Predator, other than it being PG-5 or PG-13, it was an alright movie. Prometheus was meh. The problem with Prometheus is it tried to sound smart, but it wasn't. And there's a lot of videos online that'll pick apart the logic in Prometheus and how it messes with the canon of the Aliens universe. So yeah, you could search those up if you're interested in Aliens, the Aliens franchise in general. So anyways, back to the game. We're going back to sleep. We're back in the dream world, and we're talking to Takeshi and Yoshio, who we have with us in our party now. With me and Takeshi having the same hit points, and Yoshio being a little bit weaker by nature, since I didn't put any points into his strength yet. Here's Yuriko. It's kind of awkward doing dubbing. I'm pretty sure this is like something YouTubers have to get used to. Oh, okay. There's the demon summoning right now. Or not the demon summoning, the sacrifice. They're trying to sacrifice this woman, who turns out to be the female protagonist, who we're gonna save right now from this dark priest and his satanic ritual. Sorry, I'm kind of like spoiling what's gonna happen in the audio. I'm kind of, I don't fucking know what I'm trying to do right now. As I was saying before, it's kind of just awkward trying to dub over something that is already, like, I guess it'd be more natural for me to have been playing and recording the audio at the same time. But just in general, it's kind of fucking weird to be talking to myself, like, into a microphone, like, as if you're there, or whoever's watching this is there. So we're gonna name our female heroine Yuka. Alright, so she thanks us for saving her, which is pretty sweet. This, I love this background, just fucking like, It's so cool. Just the graphics in this game in general are pretty impressive for Super Nintendo. What? Dad, I'm recording. I know I'm recording audio right now.